Crackerbelly.
Hey guys, I'm Sean.
I'm Newt.
And today we've got something a little special to show you, don't we, Newt?
Yeah, we do. I'm just getting done a 15-hour shift here at my theater. Now that we're back doing regular Underbelly episodes again, people have asked, what have we been working on for the last 2 years, other than Midnight Show, obviously? Actually, people have been saying, hey, asshole, what have you asshole idiots been working on for the last 2 years? Give you guys a little backstory on something. Back in 2007, when I was running the Broadway Theater in Pittman, New Jersey, my friend Mark Poulton, who's a comic book writer, and you might have seen his work for Arcana Comics on Coney Waves or A Cat Named Haiku, or he also wrote Savage Hawkman with Rob Liefeld for DC Comics. But back then, he did a book called The Velvet Rope, which is kind of a Tales from the Crypt style book set at a movie theater. They drew me into it because I am a sociopath, and I said, if you want to use my theater, you got to draw me into it. And we went on, and the book sold pretty well, but over the years, Mark and I had been talking about doing a feature film based on it. So back in 2010, actually the day that we shot the second ever episode of the Pokemon episode of Underbelly, I finished writing the screenplay with Mark. Last year, the president of Arcana Comics came and said, we need to have something to show the possible investors of what we can make Velvet Rope look like. And we shot two promo videos for no money in one day each. So just to kind of show these guys what we can do with limited resources. And we're going to show you both of those now. The first one we shot at the Broadway Theater in Pittman, New Jersey, where I said I used to be the manager. It starts off with our friend Mr. Lobo, who's a horror show host. You can find him on Cinema Insomnia. And he's doing kind of a satire, a parody almost on the great Leonard Nimoy 70s show In Search Of. This video also features our friend Christy Richmond, who was in many episodes of Underbelly, and creature effects by Tony DeBartolus, who worked a lot with us on Midnight Show.
When Newt and Mark asked me to shoot this, I knew that, like most of the things we shoot, there'll be limited time and we'll have to do this quick and kind of dirty. We were trying to really make it atmospheric, really playing with the fact that it's this large theater, it's old, there's sound, it's creaky, there's whispers, you know. And I thought it really came through, the atmosphericness of it. Had we had more time, more equipment and stuff like that, obviously it could have been better. Yeah. But I think it was a really good way of showing the style that we were trying to go through for that version.
Yeah, a haunted movie theater with a girl there by herself, and the main character, Velvet Rope, is a sexy usherette who died in the theater, and that's her backstory, so she's haunting the place. And your friend Janessa played Velvet in this one. She came out and did a great job.
Yes, Janessa did an excellent job. I also had a buddy from South Carolina who helped do the costume.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Which, crazy enough, ended up being created again.
Yeah.
Because we had to destroy it for this one, for the other trailer. Mm-hmm. And then that costume went off to be
LA,
in Ted 2.
You're going to see it in Ted 2 coming up when that comes out, which is kind of cool.
Yeah.
So take a look. This is the first trailer that we did for Arcana Comics for The Velvet Rope.
A cold spot, a feeling of dread, shadow in your peripheral, ghosts. Tonight on In Spite of Reality, we investigate one of the most famous and controversial hauntings of the last 20 years, the legend of Velvet Rope. Join us as we separate the facts of a young girl's untimely death with the legend that still lingers in the darkness of an unassuming movie house in a town not unlike your own.
You're cool with staying behind tonight, closing up, decorating for me?
Good night. Thanks for coming. Just go now before I change my mind.
You're the best.
Well, it looks like it's just you and me tonight.
What's going on? Where's the fire?
Was it you?
It was what me? I just came back to get my cell phone charger. What's going on?
There was something else in there with me.
Velvet Rope. Coming soon from Arcana Studios. She's saved you a seat.
So, that's the first trailer. We're very proud of it.
I think it came out great considering what we had to work with.
Absolutely.
My ego, too, is usually...
Well, it is. It cannot be contained in a room or a space.
Mm-mm. Punch drunk. I've been here all day. So that was the second trailer.
The second trailer.
We filmed up in Washington, New Jersey at the Washington Theater. Our friend Marco owns that theater, and he opened it up
really
to us.
Really cool theater.
Very cool, very kind of creepy, kind of, you know, not, I don't want to say run down, but it definitely has a grindhouse feel to it with a great marquee. This time we reached out to my friend, I was dating her at the time, Krista Robel, to come out and play Velvet in this one. And we basically just adapted the first few pages of the actual Velvet Rope graphic novel, which you can buy at Arcana Comics. And this one is also a lot of fun, too. This is the only one we had a second day of shooting, though, because we had to go back and reshoot me tied to the chair.
One of the things that I think was better about this one that really showed it feeling different, aside from Wes trying to adapt the comic book. Was that I tried to bring a few more elements of the cinematography to be a bit more flashy.
The drone.
So we had a drone shot that you'll see. I shot on a better camera, had some more lenses. We did a little bit of lighting. Mm-hmm. The whole film wrap thing was an involved sequence.
Just we shot it all in reverse.
Really mix it up. and I think it really came out nice.
Yeah, I mean, once again, like I said, very limited resources. We were just trying to give the Arcana something to show so that they can kind of see that we can make a lot with a little. And once again, we just, you know, people came out and really great and helped us out with it. So take a look at the second trailer as well.
Tickets, please. Enjoy the show. was about to start.
Velvet Rope. Coming soon from Arcana Studios. She's saved you a seat.
So those are the trailers. And I mean, we're really proud of them. Yeah. We hope that you guys like them. And you know, as usual, we want to hear your feedback. So we want to know, you know, what you liked about the trailers, what you didn't like about the trailers. We want to know, you know, if you'd go and see something like this, because if you do, we'd like you to, you know, Facebook and tweet Arcana, let them know. You know, yeah, definitely.
Go pick up the comic. I'm in it. We'll add pictures of me as a cartoon character.
Yes, it's pretty cool. Yeah. It is really neat.
The screenplay that I actually wrote with Mark Poulton is genuinely scary. It's a scary script based on my experiences working in a movie theater. There's a lot of creepy things of me being alone every night that I always thought about that I wrote into there, and we adapted to this comic, and Mark's brilliant, and we need you guys to tell them that you dig this kind of stuff, because that's going to get light a fire on them to go ahead and put this thing into production, and we're, you know, we want to make it. We want to make a really scary movie. No more of this remake crap. And did you see the Poltergeist remake? We should have covered that. It was terrible.
I know.
But, you know, we hope you guys liked it. Leave your comments below. Let us know what you thought. Go and like Arcana Comics on Facebook. Like Underbelly if you haven't liked us. And like I said, we're going to be continuing to do new stuff, but we wanted to show you guys what we've been working on for the last 2 years. And Underbelly. Velvet Rope. Velvet Rope is
what?
Melvin Rope. That's
Melvin's.
Yeah, it's my
Melvin's Rope.
It's my accountant. So thanks for watching. I don't know how to cut it.